Welcome again to Metal Weekly, the series where we bring you some of the latest releases you may have missed from a previous week. Now, this week's releases have been quite monumental. A lot of big names have released albums this week, but there's also some hidden gems, and I'll try and give you a mix of both on this episode today. But let's start it with one of the biggest, and that is the mighty Alestorm. So Alestorm just released Curse of the Crystal Coconut on Napalm Records. So let's give it a little listen. Your pirate ship can eat a bag of dicks. Your pirate ship can eat a giant bag of dicks. You better give us all the money in your treasure chest, or Kristoff's gonna take a shit on your fucking lawn. Your pirate ship can eat a bag of dicks. Yarr me hearties. This fucking record is fun. It's not for everyone. Now, you'll know if you like Alestorm. You'll know if you don't like Alestorm. If you like fun, you'll like Alestorm. That's pretty much it. If you hate fun music, get the fuck out. Curse of the Crystal Coconut is probably the most wacky, the most creative, and the most funny record they've done. It is very different to a lot of the other Alestorm records. I'll tell you that, it's very different. I've been a big fan of Alestorm since the first fucking record, and I've seen Alestorm live about 8 or 9 times. Probably the band I've seen the most live. It's because they put on a massive show and they're always fun. Curse of the Crystal Coconut is definitely worth your time if you want something fun, you want something to drink to. Don't take it seriously. This isn't an album to take seriously. There's a song called Shit Boat No Fans where he just goes, "Your ship can eat a bag of dicks." Like, that's the lyrics to the song. It's really fucking dumb. There's other stupid songs which I love, like Chomp Chomp, which has the Finn Troll singer, I think, in that one. Oh, I fucking love Chomp Chomp. Chomp Chomp. And Zombies Ate My Pirate Ship. I mean, from those titles, you know it's going to be just a stupid fucking great time. And Alestorm always deliver an amazing album. This is a lot less serious than all the others, though. I will say, it's probably not my favourite Alestorm album, but it's the most fun Alestorm album. And these songs live will be amazing. Can't wait to see them. Can't wait to fucking see them again for like the 9th time. I always go, whenever they tour, I'm 100% there. 100% there. I'm an Alestorm fanatic. Definitely check out Curse of the Crystal Coconut. It's one of the best of the week. Next up, we have Bleed From Within with Fracture on Century Media Records. Give a listen. This is not a war, it's a victory. I've looked into the eyes of misery. Cover up the truth, spread hypocrisy. From nothing you came, went into nothing, no return. Now this one right here is going to be another surprise to everyone. This is metalcore, but this may be my favourite album of the week. This is probably going to be in the top 10 albums of the month. I fucking love this album. The melodies are just so on point. The breakdowns are amazing. His singing is so aggressive. It feels like Parkway Drive just bumped up to 11. If you love the sound of Parkway Drive, you will fucking love Bleed From Within. This album has everything. Everything. Every song is a fucking 10. I know I throw that around a lot, but fuck it. It's fucking amazing. Songs like Ascend, the fucking melody is in that, the chorus in that, catchy as all fuck. The End of All We Know, which is one of the singles which came out and got me hyped for the album, starts off the album with a fucking bang, and it just keeps going. It's high intensity, high octane fun the entire way through, but my favourite song is another one of the singles, Into Nothing. When he sings that part, it's like, from nothing you came, and into nothing you return. And it just hits with the fucking breakdown. Oh, it's too good. Too fucking good. Love this song, love this album. As much as a fanboy of Alestorm I am, Bleed From Within's album better, in my opinion. Like, a little bit better. So 100% fucking check this album out, because it's my top pick of the week. Next up, something a bit different. We have Weresoul with a self-titled album out on Malignant Voices. Check it out. So this is black metal, you know, one of my favourite genres, but this is so unconventional. So unconventional black metal. It's kind of horror themed. There's a lot of like screams and like beast noises throughout. It's kind of, I love that kind of horror energy that a lot of bands, that some bands bring, I should say. It feels like Tribulation. It feels like Tribulation had a baby with like Hooded Menace. That's the sound I'm getting from this album. The themes and stuff from Hooded Menace with the sound of Tribulation, and that's kind of this album. It's hard to describe. It is definitely unique record from the week. What the hell happened to my voice then? Whee! Yeah, this album, it just has a creepy, eerie atmosphere that I just love. I love the album cover. It's creepy as fuck. Listening to this while playing Bloodborne, that's what you want to do. That's what you want to do. It's got that horrorcore atmosphere. I fucking love it. An interesting album from the week to check out. Next up, Cauldron Black Ram with Slaver, and it's on 20 bucks spin. Check it out. Now, this is an intense black and death metal album, and the vocals on it fucking rip. It has that really guttural kind of evil voice that you want. Very murky atmosphere, murky sound to everything. Feels like old school cavernous kind of death metal, but with more melody and with that blackened atmosphere as well. It's not just cavernous death metal, it's cavernous death metal plus the blackened atmosphere of, say, I don't know, like Behemoth or something. Mix that in with like a tomb mold, and then that's what you get. But that's kind of selling it short. It's his own entity, and it's fucking awesome. And the artwork is some of the best of the week. The artwork is fucking flawless. I love anything like this. He's just holding all the fucking severed heads. Oh, it's sick. And the logo for the band, it is a fucking ram. It's awesome. I fucking love everything about this album. It's aggressive, it's evil, it's interesting, and it's well worth your fucking time. Next up, something a bit different, we have Caligula's Horse with Rise Radiant on Inside Out Records. Let's listen. Now this is something a bit different, it's prog. We're having a very mixed day today. Very mixed. We got power, we got black, we had death, metalcore, and now I'm hitting you with some fucking prog. And this is really relaxing, nice prog. It's not that genty shit. It's the kind of nice, relaxing prog, which, you know, some people might not like, but I thought the album was really interesting. And it actually grabbed my attention. There's a lot of ballads on this one, but they didn't piss me off. Like, the ballads on this didn't piss me off like a lot of ballads on other prog albums or albums in general. I think it's to do with his singing and just the soft atmosphere of everything. It's pleasant. It's just pleasant. There's not too much wankery in it. It's just beautiful singing, beautiful melodies. And there is some funky parts. There is some, you know, it's prog, so there is some progressive elements and progressive parts of the songs. But it's not just what it is. You got funky stuff like Slow Violence. And then you got, like, soothing ones, kind of like The Ascent. Or The Tempest. Melodic, it's interesting, and it's one of the cooler albums I checked out from the previous week, so definitely give it a listen if you're into prog. Finally, we're ending on some just straight up fucking death metal, and we're doing the album Centinex, Death in Pieces on Argonian Record. I keep saying Argonian. Fucking Skyrim over here. Argonia Records. Fucking listen. Ending on fucking awesome death metal for you. The vocals in this feel super pained and super like, you feel his agony, you feel his anger through the songs. The vocals are sick. You feel like the energy and evilness in each fucking song. So yeah, powerful as fuck vocals on this one. Heavy as all hell. It's got that old school kind of feel. There's a lot of standout tracks. God Ends Here is probably one of them. I really fucking love that one. But I think my favourite has to be Tomb of the Dead. there's a lot of fast songs, but there's also a lot of slower death metal songs with the slower chugging riffs, which I love more in death metal. You know, one of my favorite death metal albums, Fourth Crusade by Bolt Thrower, it has those slow chugging riffs, and that's what I love. Autopsy as well. And this has some songs like that, so yeah, A star. Fucking love it. Hopefully you find something to enjoy from the week. Let me know in the comments below your favourite album from the previous week or the previous 2 weeks. Let me know in the comments below and we'll see you again on another Metal Weekly.